Hello dear students, I Ravi Taylor heartily welcome you all in this video class. Today I shall teach you your 10th chapter, the Sermon at Banaras by Betty Rinch. Banaras, also known as Kashi and Varanasi, is one of the most popular, one of the most holy places in India. The very first question which comes to your mind when you see the title The Sermon at Banaras is, who preached sermon in Banaras? Who delivered sermon in Banaras? And the answer is Gautam Buddha. Yes, dear students, in this chapter I shall teach you the life history of Gautam Buddha. We shall also have brief introduction of his early life and his transformation into a spiritual leader, into a religious teacher, and into a wonderful meditator. So let us start its line-wise explanation. Gautam Buddha began life as a prince named Siddhartha Gautam in northern India. Gautam Buddha started his life, he began his life as a prince. By birth, he was a prince, he was son of a king. In the northern part of India, and when he was born, he was named as Siddhartha Gautama. He was born in 563 BC and he died in 483 BC. At 12, he was sent away for schooling in the Hindu sacred scriptures, and 4 years later, he returned home to marry a princess. When Gautam Buddha was 12 years old, at the age of 12, he was sent for schooling to study Hindu holy scriptures, to study Hindu sacred scriptures. And 4 years later, he returned. At the age of 12, he went for schooling. And at the age of 16, he returned to marry a princess. He got married at the age of 16. They had a son. Gautam Buddha and his wife had a son, and they lived for 10 years as befitted royalty. Gautam Buddha and his wife lived their life with all the luxuries as befitted, as fit royalty. Royalty means king and they both lived their life. At about the age of 25, when Gautam Buddha was 25 years old, the prince Gautam Buddha, heretofore shielded from the sufferings of the world. Gautam Buddha, till the age of 25, was shielded, was protected from the sufferings, from the pain, from the agony of the world. Which means he did not know what pain is, what suffering is. While out hunting, chanced upon a sick man, then an aged man, then a funeral procession, and finally a monk begging for alms. By chance, he met with an old man and a sick man, and a funeral procession, and finally he saw a beggar begging for alms, begging for charity. When he was 25 years old, one day he went on hunting and he saw an old man, a sick man, a funeral procession, and a beggar begging for alms. These sights show us the suffering of the world. These sights show us the pain of the world, pain of the physical world. These sights so moved him these sights so much hunted him, these sights hunted him extremely, that he at once went out into the world to seek enlightenment concerning the sorrows he had witnessed. When he saw all these sights, he felt extremely hunted, and he went out, he left his home, and started seeking the enlightenment, started seeking the Param Gyan, which was regarding, which was concerning the sorrows he had seen. The sorrows were the pain of an old man, a sick man, a funeral procession, and a beggar. So he left his home to find out the answers of all these sufferings. He wandered for 7 years. For 7 years he kept wandering to find out the answer, to get enlightenment, and finally sit down under a peepal tree. When he did not get the enlightenment after 7 years, finally he stayed under a peepal tree and vowed to stay until enlightenment came. And he pledged that he would stay under the tree until he get enlightenment. Enlightened after 7 years. Yes, Gautam Buddha got enlightened. He got the Param Gyan after 7 days. And he renamed the tree the Bodhi tree. He renamed the peepal tree under which he sat for 7 days as Bodhi tree, which means the tree of wisdom. And he began to teach and share his new understandings. After getting enlightened, he started sharing his new understandings which he had recently got, and he started sharing his thoughts. At that point he became known as the Buddha. At that point, when he started preaching, when he started delivering his understandings to people, he was named as Buddha. The Buddha word literally means, the word Buddha literally has the meaning enlightened or awakened. Somebody who has got the Param Gyan is Buddha. The Buddha preached his first sermon at the city of Banaras. Gautam Buddha delivered his first sermon. He preached his first sermon at the city of Banaras, at the city of Kashi. And this city, Banaras city, is one of the most holy dipping places on the river Ganga. This city is considered, according to the Hindu scriptures, the most sacred, the most holy bathing place on Ganga River. That sermon has been preserved. The very first sermon which Buddha delivered in Banaras has been protected, has been preserved, has been reserved, and is given in this chapter. And we will definitely study it. It reflects the Buddha's wisdom about one inscrutable kind of suffering. In this chapter, we will see Buddha's wisdom on one of the problem in life which is almost impossible to understand, which is almost impossible to solve. So let's read it. Kisa Gautami had an only son. There was a lady whose name was Kisa Gautami, and she had only one son. She did not have any child except a son. And he died. Unfortunately, her only son died. In her grief, she carried the dead child to all her neighbors. As her child was dead, she had been extremely sad. So in her grief, she carried her child to all her neighbors. The reason behind carrying her child to the neighbors was, she asked them for medicine. People said, the answer of people was, she has lost her senses, the boy is dead. When after her son's death, Kisa Gautami carried her son to her neighbors and asked them for medicine, the obvious answer of the people was, this lady has lost her senses, this lady has gone crazy, this lady has gone mad. At length, after long, after a long time, Kisa Gautami met a man who replied to her request. After a long time, she met somebody. Kisa Gautami met a man who replied to her request. Others just kept saying she had gone crazy and did not reply. But a man, on meeting Kisa Gautami, replied her. I cannot give medicine. Here, give means to you. I cannot give you medicine. The man said that he had no medicine to cure her child, but I know a physician who can. I know a doctor, I know a physician who can cure your dead child. On hearing this, the lady said, the girl said, Kisa Gautami said, pray tell me, I request you, I beg you, please tell me the name of the person who can cure my child. And the man replied. And the man told her the name of the person who could cure her child. Sakyamuni Gautama Buddha. According to the man, the only person who could cure her child was Sakyamuni Gautama Buddha. When she came to know Gautama Buddha's name from the man, she prepared to Buddha. She went to Gautama Buddha and cried. She started crying, she started begging. Lord, Master, give me the medicine that will cure my boy. She started begging Gautama Buddha to give her such medicine which could cure her dead child. The Buddha answered. When Buddha heard her request, he did not deny it. He answered, and the answer was, I want a handful of mustard seed. Gautama Buddha said that he just wanted a handful of mustard seed. And when the girl in her joy promised to procure it, and when Gautama Buddha said that he would cure her child if she could get a handful of mustard seed, the lady became happy, the lady became joyful. And then Gautama Buddha had put his terms and conditions. The mustard seed must be taken from a house. When the lady promised Gautama Buddha that she would bring, she would procure, she would get mustard seed to cure her child, Gautama Buddha added that the seed must be taken. The condition is the seed which you are going to take must be taken from a house where no child, no husband, no parent or friend has been died. The mustard seed must be taken from a house where there had been no casualty, there had no one. Poor Kisa Gautami now went from house to house. The reason behind going house to house is to get mustard seed. And the people pitied her. Not all people are bad. Some people pitied her, some people showed mercy on her and said, here is your mustard seed. They all offered her mustard seed, they gave her mustard seed. But when she asked, did a son or a daughter, a father or mother die in your family? But when Kisa Gautami asked them whether they had lost any of their beloved one or not, they answered to her, alas, the living are few, but the dead are many. Almost everybody replied that they had lost many dear ones in their lives, many dear and near ones in their family. The one who are present are few, and those who are gone, those who are dead are many. Do not remind us of our deepest duty. People said that, people requested her to not to remind them of their deepest grief, and their deepest grief was to lose their loved ones. The deepest grief in this world is to lose our loved ones. And there was no house but some beloved one had died in it. She could not get a house where no loved one hai, no dear and near one hai, died. And finally, after wandering home to home, Kisa Gautami became tired. Kisa Gautami became very weary and hopeless. Kisa Gautami became weary, tired and hopeless. She had no hopes. Because almost everybody like her same. Everybody had lost somebody in his or her family. And she sat down at the wayside. She sat down at the wayside watching the lights of the city. And while she was watching the lights of the city, something came in her mind. The lights were flickering up and were extinguished again. When she saw the lights, first of all, the lights were flickering, the lights were twinkling, and later on the lights, extinguished light, put out. At last, the darkness of the light went everywhere. At last, finally, the darkness ruled everywhere, which means there were darkness everywhere in the city. And she considered the fate of the man. Here she considered, here she understood, here she thought the fate of a man, the destiny of a man. That the life flicker up, that the life of a man flicker up, it twinkles, it is always in the risk of getting dead, getting finished, and are extinguished again. And finally, a man's life, finally a man dies. And she thought to herself, and now she thought, how selfish I am in my grief. She thought that she had been very selfish when she was sad. And she, because death is common to all, she understood that is that it's common to all. Death is the eternal truth of life. Death is the universal truth. Yet in this valley of desolation, yet in this valley of desolation means in the world full of sorrows and grief, there is a path. Yes, there is a way that leads us to immortality. There is a way in this valley of desolation, in this world full of sorrow and grief, there is a way which can make us immortal. Now you guys want to know the way. And the way is, we should abandon all our selfishness. If we abandon, if we leave, if we forsake our selfishness, if we become selfless, we can be immortal. Because death is the eternal truth of life. The one who has born in this world will have to die. So finally she understood that by being selfless, a man can become immortal. Now tomorrow we shall read Gautam Buddha's son. Till then, stay safe.